New York honors for Poppy duo, Joan Collins and John Hurt. The creators of the World War I ceramic poppy display at the Tower of London have joined acting grandees Joan Collins and John Hurt on the New Year honors list. Ceramic artist Paul Cummins and theater designer Tom Piper are both made MBEs in recognition of the blood-swept lands and seas of red installation which attracted 5 million visitors. The acting profession is strongly represented on the list, with Collins and Kristen Scott Thomas becoming dames and Hurt knighted. There is an OBE for Emily Watson, as well as James Corden and Sheridan Smith, who appeared together in TV sitcom Gavin and Stacey. A total of 1,164 people are honored by the Queen on the New Year list, three-quarters of whom have been recognized for work in their communities. The awards are split equally between men and women. And a further 87 recipients are named on the Foreign Office list which recognizes service overseas. Poppy installation at Tower of London. About 5 million people visited the poppy installation. Dame Joan, who was made an OBE for her contribution to the arts in 1997, is recognized this time for services to charity. She said she was thrilled and truly grateful. Dame Kristen, who is shortly to play the Queen on stage in the audience, said she was thrilled, astonished, and worried that I might suddenly wake up. Among the other new dames are fashion designer Mary Quant, broadcaster Esther Ranson, founder of the Childline and Silver Line charities, and poet laureate Carol Ann Duffy. Trevor Hicks and Margaret Aspinall, who campaigned for a quarter of a century for the families of the 96 football fans who died in the Hillsborough disaster, are made CBEs. A new inquest into the deaths is still going on. Women's Rugby World Cup winners Sarah Hunter and Rochelle Clark are among the sports stars recognized with MBEs. Athlete Steve Cram, a former 1500m world champion, becomes a CBE in recognition of his recent work as chair of the English Institute of Sport. The same honor goes to novelist Ali Smith. Meanwhile, an inquiry is to be carried out into the apparent leaking of a string of names from the list before they were officially announced. Sir Bob Kerslake, the outgoing head of the civil service, said he was concerned, describing the situation as highly regrettable. Continue reading the main story. New Year Honors 2015. 1,251. People honored. 69% for outstanding work in their communities. 49% are women. 22 men receive knighthoods. 16 women become dames. Source, Cabinet Office/Foreign Office. The poppy installation saw 888,246 ceramic flowers gradually fill the moat of the Tower of London, each one representing a British and Commonwealth military death in World War I. The Queen referred to the artwork in her Christmas message. Mr. Cummins said he felt taken aback and extremely happy to receive this unexpected honor. He said everyone who had worked on the project should feel a part of this MBE, without them this installation wouldn't have been created. Mr. Piper added, I am extremely proud of the part I have played in this unique collaboration. It has been a real privilege to co-create an artwork which has meant so much to so many people. Dame Esther said, I am thrilled that this honor recognizes the contribution made by Childline and the Silver Line in transforming lives, and I am delighted that the talented teams at both charities have also been recognized for their inspirational work and devotion to the most vulnerable children and older people in our society. Game success. Among the political honors, former Liberal Democrat leader Lord Paddy Ashdown is appointed a member of the elite Companions of Honor. Stirling MP Anne Maguire becomes a dame and Southend West MP David Amos is knighted. Baroness Ashton, the former EU foreign policy chief, has been made a member of the Order of St. Michael and St. George. Dame Mary Peters, who won a gold medal in the women's pentathlon at the 1972 Olympic Games in Munich, also joins the Companion of Honor. The honors for sport also acknowledge the work of ex-West Bromwich Albion footballer and racial equality campaigner Brendan Batson, who becomes an OBE. Great Britain hockey captain Catherine Richardson Walsh, as well as Northern Ireland boxer Patrick Barnes and Scotland judo player Ewan Burton, who both won gold at the 2014 Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, all get MBEs. Jump media player help out of media player. Press enter to return or tap to continue. Dame Esther Ranson, I am used to very grand people being dames and I can't really adjust. The success of the games itself is recognized, with a CBE for Glasgow City Council leader Gordon Matheson and an OBE for Commonwealth Games Scotland Chief Executive John Doig. Others from the world of entertainment on the list include comedian and author Mira Siel and Grammy-winning producer and one half of 1960s pop duo Peter and Gordon, Peter Asher. Both become CBEs. Aldebaran Music Chief Executive and former BBC Proms Director Roger Wright, who receives a CBE, said he was thrilled to be honored for my work in the service of music. Oscar-nominated screenwriter William Nicholson, whose work includes Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom, Les Miserables, and Gladiator, collects an OBE. In the world of business, Wind Up Radio inventor Trevor Bayliss is appointed CBE, as are entrepreneur James Cann, who appeared on TV show Dragon's Den, and Brent Hoberman, who co-founded travel website lastminute.com with Martha Lane Fox in 1998. There is an OBE for Julie Dean, CEO owner and founder of the Cambridge Satchel Company. Youth Channel. There is a knighthood for Dr. Simon Campbell, who played a key role in the development of Viagra while he was senior vice president at pharmaceuticals giant Pfizer. Jump media player help out of media player. Press enter to return or tap to continue. Jamal Edwards, one of youngest people to be awarded an MBE. Jamal Edwards, who founded influential youth broadcasting channel SBTV, becomes an MBE. The 24-year-old entrepreneur from West London, who helped launch the career of Ed Sheeran among others, said, "I'm overwhelmed. My gran doesn't know yet. My mum and dad know, but that's it." Former Lord Mayor of London, Fiona Wolfe is named a dame for services to the legal profession, diversity, and the City of London. She stood down as the head of the inquiry into how public bodies dealt with historical child abuse allegations earlier this year. Jump media player help out of media player. Press enter to return or tap to continue. Trevor Hicks, I'm a bloke who's done a job of work to the best of his ability. Kate Lampard, who oversaw the NHS investigation into Jimmy Savile, and Britain's most senior female police officer, Cressida Dick, who is to leave the Metropolitan Police after 31 years, both become CBEs. There are knighthoods for Home Chief Inspector of Constabulary Tom Windsor and former Police Service of Northern Ireland Chief Constable Matt Baggett. David Veery, chairman of the Art Fund, which provided funding for the Veery Galley at Eton College, now open to the public, is also knighted. Two Network Rail executives are also on the list. Patrick Hallgate, a route managing director involved in the repair of the flood-hit line at Dawlish in Devon, becomes an MBE for services to the economy in the Southwest. David Ward, route managing director for the Southeast, is given an OBE for services to the rail industry. Marathon runner. In a rare occurrence, two members of the same family are recognized for separate activities on the same list. Mary O'Keefe receives an MBE for services to people with disabilities through her work as chief executive of Lookie House in East Lothian. Her mother Catriona McKinnon receives a British Empire Medal, BEM, for services to the Gaelic language and culture. Steve Cram. Steve Cram is made a CBE for services to sport. Kristen Scott Thomas. English patient star Kristen Scott Thomas is to play the Queen on stage. Fauja Singh, who at 103 years old is widely recognized as the oldest marathon runner in the world, is also given a BEM. Among the less heralded recipients, there is a BEM for Joanne Copsey, a town pastor in Bury St. Edmunds, Suffolk, who co-ordinates a team of 50 volunteers working with the police to ensure people are safe on the streets at night. Hazel Geach, who has given more than four decades of dedicated service to the scouting movement in Romford, Essex, is made an MBE. There is also an MBE for Gbola and Bright, founder of Bright Futures, which provides counseling and mentoring to young people with behavioral problems.